24, I'm the oldest of 21 kids, but now I want to tell you a story about when we were just a little small family with only 7 kids. My parents were 24 and 26, and I was 6 years old. And as you may have guessed, no, we weren't Catholic, we were Mormon. And my dad was not a member of the church when my parents got married, and so they got married civilly with the line, you'll be together until death do you part. But by the time they had 7 kids, they had figured out they wanted to be together and they were going to need a long time to raise all these kids. So they decided to go to the Mormon temple and be married for time and all eternity, to be sealed together and to have their children sealed to them so that after this life we would all be stuck together forever. And so they loaded us all up with my grandparents in a borrowed Volkswagen van, and we drove from Missouri to Washington, D.C., which is where the closest temple was at that time. And I remember that trip. It was very memorable being stuck into this car with that many kids and an aunt and my 2 grandparents and my parents. And I had a special spot. We all had our spot on the floor. There weren't seatbelt laws back then, and to fit us all in, we were just all packed all around on the floor. And my spot was next to the door, the sliding door, because I could be trusted not to touch the door handle and open the door while we were driving down the highway. And they knew I could be trusted because they scared me to death by telling me about how horrible my death would be if I did that and fell out onto the highway. And at nap time, at bedtime, I could lay down and there was a crack between the door and the bus, and I could see the highway going by underneath us. And I was very nervous and scared about that, and very scared about the doorknob, and plus we hadn't even made it to the temple yet to be sealed together. So if I died, I'd be alone. But anyway, we made it to D.C. We made it to D.C. and we went and saw the Capitol building, we saw the White House, and it was very impressive, this huge city, and it was beautiful. And then we went to the temple, and it was more beautiful than every place that we'd seen. Huge and marble and white with a statue, the golden statue of an angel on the top. And it made sense to me because, you know, the president had the White House, but this was God's house, so it made sense that it looked so much better. But so we go to the temple, and they take us. All the people in the temple that work in the temple are volunteers, and they're usually older people with white or silver hair, and they all wear white, and they float around and whisper. And they took my parents away to be married again, and they took all of us to this incredible nursery, like a nursery in a palace, full of toys and juice and snacks and coloring books and this army of grandmas in white to take care of us while we waited. And so we waited, and then they came and said that my parents were almost ready for us. And they opened these doors, these closets in the walls, and there were just all of these rows of white clothes, little white dresses and little white slips and socks and little white slippers. And they dressed us all and put white ribbons in our hair and washed our faces and brushed our hair and told us how beautiful we were and what a special day it was. And then they led us through the halls of the temple, and people came out to see us. They'd heard about us, this huge family being sealed together, and everyone was weeping and patting us on our heads and touching our arms. And then they took us to the room where my parents were waiting for us, and my parents were in white and kneeling at an altar. And the room in the temple is covered with mirrors, and we gathered around my parents, and they showed us how our reflections bounced back and forth in these mirrors so that we could see us together for eternity. And we had to put all of our hands together on the altar, and they said a prayer to seal us together. But my youngest sister at the time, the 7th, Musette, she's sitting in the back, she pulled her hand out 3 times, so they had to start the prayer over 3 times. And so afterwards, everyone joked that my parents were sealed to 21 kids. Isn't that funny? Oh, we laughed about that for years. It was a very memorable experience and a beautiful experience. And of course, the other 2/3 of my brothers and sisters weren't born at the time. And so they don't have this memory, and most of the ones that were alive at the time were too young to remember, but I remember, and now my grandparents are gone and have died and are waiting for us. And even though my parents and my family were not perfect, a lot of times they were crazy, and a lot of times I wasn't sure if I wanted to be stuck with them forever. Because of this memory and because of this trip, I knew they always wanted to be better, and I knew they wanted to be with me forever. So I'm really thankful for that, and thankful that I'm here and can tell you about it. Thank you.